everyone. I am Rachel, and I am the Family Life intern right now here at St. Paul. And I am so very excited to be doing this chapel today. You might be wondering why I'm taking this video in my car. And it is because I have a story to tell that very much involves my vehicle. And the story also involves what you see in my trunk, which I'll let you see there. It's a tire. In fact, it is four tires, two of which are destroyed and two of which are still good. And you might be asking yourself, why would Rachel have tires in her trunk? And 48 hours ago, I would not have known, but now I do. And so let me share with you guys a fun little story about my weekend. I, on Sunday, had a friend offer me to go up to a campsite and meet them there and, you know, camp in a tent by their campsite. And I decided to do that. So I got my puppy, got on the road, made it an hour and 40 minutes away from home, but I was still an hour away from the campsite. When all of a sudden, the right side of my car started to sink. I don't know what happened. I either hit something or there was a pothole. I do not know, but something must have been in the road that was not good for my tires, because I had two flat tires and I was on the side of the freeway 2 hours away from home. So, like, it was kind of terrifying. Luckily, I was by an exit ramp at least. So it was kind of like, it was like a little bit, like there was a little more room for me on the side of the road. So I felt a little bit less in danger, but it was very terrifying. And I had my puppy with me in the car and he was terrified. He's 6 months old. His name is Snoopy. And it was just not a great situation. And I don't know, have you guys ever had situations like that? Like where things just go the worst possible way that you think they could go. And it just seems like it can't get any worse. And on top of that, not only was I 2 hours away from home on the side of the freeway, but it was a holiday weekend. And so that made it very hard to get a tow truck there. And so I was there for 2 hours on the side of the road before I got a tow truck that came to take me in my car to the shop. And then I had to have my friends come get me because the shop wasn't open, so they couldn't fix my car until like Tuesday. So it was just a very stressful situation. And it was also the 3-year anniversary of my father going to be with Jesus. And so it was a challenging day, to say the least. And in all of it, I just kept thinking, okay, like, come on now. Like, God, what are you doing here? Why are you letting all these things happen? When all of a sudden it just hit me that it was going to be okay. That I was a child of God. That I was loved by Him. That I didn't need to have everything fixed and figured out on my own, because the God of the universe was present with me in those moments. And for a brief moment before the tow truck arrived, I sat out on the side of the freeway in the grass with my puppy, and I just breathed. And I, as I think back on it, I think about Psalm 46, verse 10, where it tells us to be still. Be still and know that I am God. And it can be very hard to do that. And it's not easy, especially when we're in those moments when we are on, metaphorically on the side of the road 2 hours away from home, when we are away from what's comfortable, when we feel all alone. I felt very alone, and it was very hard as I sat there. And obviously the situation all worked out. I'm back in my car, it's fixed, everything is fine as far as that goes. But if you asked me 48 hours ago if it was gonna work out, like, I really didn't know what was gonna happen. And it was really scared to not know it. I had to trust that God was in control in the midst of it, and that he was going to provide in all the ways that I needed for him to provide. And he did. He did provide. And as I was reflecting, I even, you know, came to realize that, like, just how many things I have that I take for granted. The roof that I have over my head at home. The fact that I have a vehicle that I can drive to get from A to B. Having a puppy is a blessing. I have food and water, you know. And so even in the midst of sitting on the side of the road, even though it was terrifying and scary and uncomfortable, I knew that I had all the resources I needed, and I knew that I was going to have food that night, that I was going to have a place to stay that night, no matter what. And I knew that, like, I didn't have to worry about that stuff. And for some people, that's a big worry. That's a big concern. And so it was just really awesome to have God kind of show me that he's the provider, and that I just needed to rest in him and trust in him. And I also just, what also has come to mind in this is the verse from Philippians chapter 4, when Paul, the apostle, is talking to the church in Philippi, and he writes them this letter, and in there he talks about being content. And he says, you know, that he's learned the secret to be content both with nothing and also content when he has everything he needs. And that, like, in Christ, he has come to realize that he can do all things through Christ who strengthens him. And you guys are probably familiar with that verse, Philippians 4:13. And then there's a long list of things that Paul says, you know, to focus on what is good and admirable and right and pure. I think often, you know, you might hear the verse, "For I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." You might hear it often at sporting events or in ways that are kind of out of context and not the way that it's meant. You know, the verse does not mean that I can just right now go and run a marathon, because I have not been training for a marathon. And if I went to run a marathon right now, I would probably somehow get some sort of injury, or I would just give up after like a mile, because I don't run that often. And so that wouldn't work. But what it is saying is that everything that God lays out for me, everything that God puts in front of me, he is going to give me strength to do. He is going to give me strength to do the things that I need to do. And that goes for you guys too. Whatever you guys are experiencing right now, God is present with you, and he gives you strength, and he dwells in you. If you are a child of God, you have the Holy Spirit, and the God of the universe dwells in you. You are his temple. And that is pretty amazing. And to be honest, like, it's a weird thing to think about, like, being the temples of God. Like, that's so, it just feels so big. It feels too big. It feels like something that is too big for little old me, or, you know, or anybody. And yet, like, that is the beauty of being children of God, is that we have been given the Holy Spirit, and in him, you can do all things that God has in store for you. And as his temples, you guys get to show his love and his care and his light to those around you. You guys get to comfort those around you who need comfort. You get to show compassion to those around you who need compassion. You get to be the hands and feet of Jesus. And the Holy Spirit, which dwells in you, enables you to do that in everything. And at the end of the day, you are loved children of God, and he sent his son, Jesus, to die for you, so that you could have life eternally with him and forgiveness of sins. That's some pretty great news. So I don't know about you guys, but I wanna thank God for that, and just spend some time asking him to help us to be still in him, to know that he's with us, and to be able to be the his presence in this world. And so will you guys please pray with me? Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for this opportunity today to spend some time reflecting on you, reflecting on your word. And God, I just come before you right now thanking you especially, Lord, for being present with us in everything, for giving us your spirit, Lord, so that we can be your presence to the world. And God, I also thank you for sending your son Jesus to die for all of our sins. And God, I thank you for providing. I thank you for giving us strength. Jesus, thank you. And Heavenly Father, I come before you and I ask that you would be with all of these boys and girls today, Lord, that you would help them, to point people to you, Lord, that they would be your presence, both in the school and in their families and everywhere that they go, that they would be your loving presence to those around them, Lord. And I ask that you would help them to know that you're present with them. And God, I ask that that you would help us all to have a great rest of the week, that you would help us to be still in you and to remember that you are in control in the midst of everything that we face. And Jesus, I praise you again for your provision in all things. And it is in your name that we pray, Jesus. Amen. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching this. And I hope that you have a great rest of your Wednesday. Alrighty, bye.
Wake up and breathe in deeper than yesterday. yesterday. Take on the morning like your soul's been remade. Roll down the windows, let your cares fly away. Good things are yours to claim, you don't have to wait, yeah. All across the sky, new mercies rise, and the future's bright. This is a new day, everything's bursting with hope, coming alive.
We're collecting chapel offerings from Mount Children's Hospital. You can bring in toys, games, or beanies.
Now let's take a look at some possible items.
Hand sanitizer?
No.
That's not a good toy.
Beanie
Boos? Yeah, kids love Beanie Boos.
Dum Dums?
No.
No candy, please.
Legos?
Yeah, Legos are perfect.
Caesars.
Yes.
Those are very helpful for babies.
Uno games. Yes.
They especially are looking for Uno games for older kids.
And finally,
the baby rattles. The baby rattles. Those are great toys for little babies. All right. Thank you so much for being willing to bring in supplies to donate to chapel. This is our last chapel offering of the year, and we will be collecting these items underneath the bulletin board that's in between the elementary and middle school hallways. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.
So the third grade students worked together to choose a couple of items that we wanted to donate to Mott's Children's Hospital as a class. And some of the items you just saw in the video are ones that the third grade class picked out. They picked out the cute puppy Beanie Boo, and they also picked out the car Lego set. So you might want to pick out some items to donate as a class, just like third grade did. Thank you guys. Thank you, third grade.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is a new day. Don't let it slip away. Don't let it slip away. This is a new day. The old is gone away, the old is gone away, this is a new day. Don't let it slip away, don't let it slip away. Love hasn't given up on you, love hasn't given up on you. Love is making the old things new today and every single day. Love hasn't given up on you, love hasn't given up on you.
It's time for you to start your day.